Good afternoon. Welcome to Mass at St. Gregory the Great Parish. My name is Ronnie Varish. I'll be your lector at this Mass. Our celebrant is Father Rob, assisted by Deacon Paul. Next Sunday, please come to the pancake breakfast in the Ministry Center from 8:45 to noon. Tickets are available at the door. St. Vincent de Paul food pantry supplies are at an all-time low. Please see the bulletin for information on the heart-to-heart food drive and bring bags of non-perishable foods that weekend. Youth in grade 4 or above who have made their first communion are invited to attend altar server training on Tuesday, February the 6th, or Saturday, February the 10th. Please RSVP to let us know which session your child will attend. See details in the bulletin. Please take and read the bulletin for information on Lenten Journey events, the Sleep in Heavenly Peace bedding collection, and much more. Readings for this liturgy are located at number 1209 in the Gather Book. At this time, I ask you to please stand and welcome all those around you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
to prepare ourselves to enter into these mysteries on this wonderful sunshine day. Let's take a moment to look at those dark areas still within us that need to be redeemed and forgiven. And let's ask God for that grace.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners to trust in your healing in our lives. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, "Is not a man's life on earth a drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, when shall I arise?' then the night drags on. I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed upon me, and woe to me if I do not preach it. If I do so willingly, I have a recompense. But if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? that, when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I become weak, to win over the weak. I have become all things to all, to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. As we continue our journey during this first part of ordinary time, we continue to hear from Jesus about the day-to-day carrying out of ministry, healing the sick, casting out demons, and freeing people from anything that they were struggling with, physically, mentally, and spiritually. In fact, as Christians, it's always refreshing and assuring for us to see what Christianity looked like at the time of Jesus and what it should reflect in each of us today. We also hear of the great Christian witnesses like St. Paul going place to place to minister the gospel message. And there's one gigantic question I ask myself every time now and then is, how did they keep up the momentum? In the particular instance of today's gospel, we witness Jesus at the synagogue and then moving into the house of Simon and Andrew, where Simon's mother-in-law was ill with poor health. Now, the synagogue was no further from where Deacon Paul is seated to the terrazzo floor. Probably the whole town of Capernaum could fit inside this church. All right, this is close. And it's once that Jesus hears about her, he went to her immediately and cured her. Who do we take our troubles to? Jesus' disciples freely brought their troubles to him because they found him ready and able to deal with the difficulties, the afflictions, or sicknesses which they encountered. When Simon Peter brought Jesus to his home, his mother-in-law was instantly healed because Jesus heard Simon's prayer. And that obviously led the people of the town to bring to Jesus all of those who were in need of help, and he obviously and generously offered his assistance. And then we're told that he moves on from that place the next day, so that he can continue his public ministry to those in need. This obviously was what St. Paul put in his letter to the Corinthians, which was our second reading today, is our responsibility as Christians to continue to preach the gospel and to be all things to all people, and to ensure them that they all have the opportunity of salvation. And there's an instinct in each one of us as Christians, as followers of Jesus, to continue to do. Because that's our very nature. And yet, if we're not careful, you and I can run out of steam, which ultimately leads to burnout, which can make us not the best that we were meant to be. And in today's gospel, there's this tiny indication of a detail that can be enriching and beneficial to all of us. We're told that Jesus retreated, that he separated himself from his disciples, from the distractions and the surrounding demands around him. And early in the morning, Jesus sought to acquire a place to pray, to regain his spiritual strength for whatever he was to encounter the next day and into the future. Jesus discerned when it was necessary to stop. Do we ever take that opportunity to stop and to talk to God in our everyday lives? Do we ever take that opportunity, possibly at night before bed, to examine our conscience, to see how we've witnessed to Jesus? Those moments of grace, those moments of omission, any time that our actions failed to respond to that invitation of God's growth. We are people that always give and give and seldom or never receive. My dear friends, please remember that you and I still need saving too, and that this is our call to holiness, our time to deepen our relationship with God by our words, our deeds, and our actions, drawing us closer and closer to Jesus. Do we, you and I, allow Jesus to be our Lord and healer in our personal lives, in the midst of our families, in this, our community? Today's lesson teaches us that we can approach the Lord with expectant faith. And it's there that God's healing power restores us, not only to health, but even more powerfully to active service and care of others. There's no trouble that God doesn't want to help, and us through, or any bondage that Jesus can't set us free from. So we have to ask ourselves that question again. In times of trouble, do I come with expectant faith that the Lord will help me? This, our sacred journey toward salvation, God gives all of us this opportunity once again to go deeper and deeper and come close to Him. My dear friends, in less than a week and a half, Lent approaches. And God gives us Lent as an opportunity to grow closer to Him. And if we're in our 80s and 90s and 100, He's given us a lot of grace to come closer and be holier to Him. Maybe this is our time for us to reassess and to ask ourselves that deep, penetrating question: how can I be enriched, supplemented, and to support my hunger for a more spiritual life? Just like Simon's mother-in-law, all of us need others to help us, to bring us closer to God's unconditional love. Let's prepare ourselves. We got 10 days to think about it. And just like Jesus in today's gospel, we need to find a space, we need to find a location, an opportunity, and time to reignite that grace of God for each of us to live out our vocation. That through this Lenten season, you and I may grow closer into that likeness and image of God as we prepare ourselves to celebrate new life. Let us together profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty, and from there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Lord our God, we, like Simon, come to you today, and we ask you to hear our prayers.
For the Church, that crying out for justice, she may bring the light of faith to those searching for truth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all leaders of the world, may they continue to work for peace, and that mutual distrust and prejudice may be resolved by non-violent means. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all catechumens, may they be filled with the hope for the life-giving Spirit as they prepare themselves thoroughly for the sacraments of initiation and full communion with the Catholic faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those discerning their vocations, may they be guided by the Holy Spirit to respond to the Lord's call with generous hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish families, may they benefit from the fruits of a Eucharistic revival by spending more time in the Eucharistic adoration. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Father Joseph Haynes, whom we pray for in a special way at this Mass, and for our own prayers and intentions, which we now offer in prayerful silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died in faith, may they be granted the rewards and blessings of the kingdom, especially those who have passed on this week from our parish and faith community. Robert Shanahan, Vincine Lovallo, Teresa Principal, Sandra Litt. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord our God, you have heard the prayers of your people. Strengthen us to keep focus on you. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our ushers will now take up the collection. The gift bearers are Jay and Donna Stefan.
Today.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O Lord our God, who once established and created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that we may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty, our salvation, always, everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as though your beloved Son, you created our human race, and so through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is our right, with all your creatures, to serve you, and all the redeemed to praise you, and all the saints with one heart to bless you. Therefore, we too exalt with all the angels, and in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy and to be glorified, O God, who loves the human race and who always walks with us on this journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present here in our midst. And when we are gathered by your love, and when, as once for the disciples, and now for us, you open the scriptures and break the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, he gave you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, Holy Father, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, who led us through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the works of your love till he comes again, and we offer to you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking in this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit, and grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son. Confirm us in the bonds of communion, that together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests, deacons, religious, and your entire people, grant that all of the faithful of the church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and their pain, their joy and their hope, we may faithfully bring the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way to your kingdom. Remember also our brothers and sisters that have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith alone you have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us that when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to that eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, your martyrs, Saint Pius, Saint Gregory, and all of your saints, we shall praise and exalt you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. It's at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching that we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always freed from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. Peace I leave you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other.
Ooh. That's okay.
Nope.
And now let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
My friends, this is Jesus, not at the house of Simon's mother-in-law, but here in our midst. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those that are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and
my soul shall be healed.
With diseases, and those who were troubled by unclean spirits came unto him, because a power emanated from him, which healed them all. I will bless the Lord at all times. Praise of him is always in my mouth.
Look towards him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. A multitude with diseases and those who were troubled by unclean spirits came unto him because of power emanated from him, which healed them all.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God, who have willed that we should be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of our world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A few announcements. It's our last chance to submit your input for the name of our family of parishes. Fill out the form on the cover of the bulletin and submit your ideas by Monday. Top choices will be voted on in a future bulletin. During Lent, St. Greg's will have 4 adult confirmation classes on Wednesday evenings. If you desire to be confirmed at the Easter Vigil, please contact the parish office for more information. Exciting events are coming up soon for youth ministry. High School Havoc is Friday the 9th and 10th in the Ministry Center. Middle School Lasertron is February 16th. A high school retreat at Canturner is March 1st through 3rd. The 8th grade lock-in is March 16th and 17th. Please see the bulletin for more youth ministry or their website. Also following this liturgy today is the 5th of the first Friday devotions, and it will be held in our gathering room. Immediately following this Mass, once we do our prayer for renewal, we will do a general blessing of St. Blaise upon each of us to keep us free from throats and ailments. And the sacrament of healing will be offered immediately after Mass, if you'd like the sacrament. I think I got it all.
Good job.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God. Our prayer for renewal. In every age, O God, you have called us to be your people, to be your church. In this time, we begin anew to discern the pathways that will lead us, your people, closer to you. Continually bless our journey as we proclaim your good news, celebrate your saving presence among us, serve others with charity and justice, and steward the world you have entrusted to our care. Send your Spirit to lead and to guide our Emmaus journey as we commit ourselves to the renewal of our church. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Through the intercession of St. Blaise, Bishop and Martyr, may God cure you of every ailment of the throat and any other ailments. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Oh,
protects you against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.